say anything about the house.
All right, who's going first?
You go first?
All right. Okay. I vow. I vow not to fart in public. Tell inappropriate fart jokes with the following exceptions. Weddings. And days of the week that ended long. Enough of that, Thursdays.
I probably don't need that on that, yes.
You're good.
So that was just a little foolishness for the leaving session. Okay, tonight, Lauren, we are entering into marriage. Above all, marriage is commitment. I believe this commitment will lead us to a deeper, even more meaningful relationship. I consider myself a fortunate man to be married to you. I'm blessed. I've learned so much from you and learned so much from being in relationship with you. And I thank you. Thank you for that. I would like to continue to learn and grow and evolve along with you, even as I acknowledge that this growth process can be challenging and sometimes humbling. Everybody, we're all on our own unique and personal life paths. I'll do my best to support you on your path in any way that I can. I will care for you, and I hope you will feel as cared for as you make me feel. I will treat you respectfully because I really respect you a lot. I will give you my attention. I will endeavor to really hear you and to understand you and to accept you. We are partners. And we make a great team, maybe as good as the 2014 Mississippi State Bulldogs with Dak Prescott. And we're partners with differing strengths and weaknesses, but our strengths are complementary. I offer my strengths to you and to our partners. As we're partners, I will share with you. I will share with you materially, and I will share myself with you emotionally and spiritually. As your partner, I will revel in your good fortune and your personal wins and comfort you in disappointments and disappointments. We are also individuals and thus have a healthy need for some independence. I appreciate the generous room that you give me to be myself, and I offer you the same. Your awesome son, Miles, I offer my friendship and my guidance and my love. Generosity, kindness, consideration, humor, honesty, compromise, forgiveness, these are all things that I value and I hope to foster. For full disclosure, I will be bringing with me a host of flaws and imperfections. Too many to list here because I think we only have the space till around 9 or something.
She already knows it.
I look forward to a lot that continues to grow and expand and mature as we travel down the path together. I would like for you to feel as comfortable and secure in my love as I do in yours. So just know that I love you.
Oh. Wow. Okay, I think you cheated. I think you just
plagiarized.
Yeah, you must have just taken my iPad and copied my okay. I want you to feel how much I love you. I invite you to savor and enjoy this moment with the whole evening. I love you completely as you are right now. You are enough. love you because you support and encourage me to be my best loving self. Because you question me and challenge me and hold me accountable in a loving way. Which I don't necessarily like sometimes. I love you because of your generous heart. Your generous heart gives money to the homeless person on the street corner, the food bank, or the animal shelter. I love you because your kind heart leads you to cut our neighbor's grass. I love you because your perspective is often, if not always, different from mine. This reminds me that things are never black and white, and that I'm not always right. Who knew? Certainly not me. I love you because your friendliness allows you to strike up a conversation with anyone. I love you because you feel your feelings and you let yourself cry. I love you because you let me cry when I'm sad and you hold me. I love you because you make me laugh and encourage me to be lighthearted. I love your touch because you have especially sensitive hands, and that is my love. I love you because you are willing to tell me the truth and are willing to have hard conversations. And that's also not my favorite thing to do. I love you because you are a father to Miles. You support him, you hold him accountable, giving advice and words of encouragement, and you love. I love your curiosity and your willingness to ask questions for clarification. I love your beautiful blue eyes and your affectionate smile. I love your dedication to spiritual growth and the conversations we have together about it. I love your ability to forgive and apologize, which encourages me to do the same. I love your courage to do something you have never done before, like build a shed, and the perseverance to complete it, even though you hate me. I love how you listen to me when I have a rough day. I mean you. A rough you. I love how you nurture your relationships with your family and my family and your friends. I love your imperfections because it reminds me that I am imperfect and human too. I love who you are becoming as we continue to learn and laugh and live our lives together. I love you just as you are, so don't try to go changing to try to fix it. I vow to always let you fold the laundry because you do it 1,000 times better than me. I vow to always let you dispose of dead critters that Sweet Pea brings to our back door as gifts. I vow to always let you load the dishwasher because you load it most efficiently. And I vow always to have Advil in my purse and room for your reading glasses. No, true. I promise to love myself wholeheartedly. I promise to be imperfect and accept my gifts of imperfections. I promise to apologize when I am wrong, if that ever happens to you. I will do my best to speak with integrity. I will do my best not to take anything personally. I will do my best to have the courage to ask questions instead of making assumptions. So you tell which books I read. I promise to be an equal partner in our relationship. I promise to bring up things when they are bothering me. I promise to show my affection to you. I promise to continue my spiritual growth and keep my heart open. I promise to support you and encourage you to be your best self. I promise to help you and ask for help. And I promise to practice courage, gratitude, forgiveness, I promise to do my best to cultivate lightheartedness, humor, and silliness. And I promise to take responsibility for the quality of our life together in the good times and bad. I promise to love